Hi children, now let us see about division of whole number by a fraction. I'm going to divide a whole number and a fraction by fraction. Okay, let me consider the whole number to be 1 now. To begin with, let us have the whole number to be 1 and that fraction be 1 by 2. That is, I'm going to divide this 1 by 1 by 2. How it's possible? I'm going to divide any number by a whole number. That we are familiar. If I have to divide 1 into half, I can cut that 1 into half. So, how many halves will I have if I cut that 1 into half pieces? How many will I have? 2 pieces I will have. That's the meaning of 1 is divided into half. That 1 is divided into half of pieces. How many half I have? 2. So I can say 1 divided by 2 as 2. 1 divided by half is equal to 2. Is it clear, my dear children? Now let us see one more example. When 3 is to be divided by 1 by 4. I have to divide 3 circles into quarters 1 by 4. How many quarters will I have? Now see this picture, it will be very clear for you. This is 1, this is another 1, this is another 1. So totally I have 3 whole, 3 whole. These are 3 holes. A hole means W-H-O-L-E, not a empty space. This is a hole, W-H-O-L-E, hole. This whole part is divided into quarter pieces. How many quarters do I have in this one hole? 4 quarters. Here how many quarters? Another 4. Here another 4. Totally how many quarters do I have in this 3 holes? I have 12 quarters. So I can say 3 divided by 1 by 4 is equal to 12. Is it possible for me to do drawings every time to find this division? It is not possible. We should have a system to find it directly. How have I got this answer 12? Any guessing, my dear children? Is there any relationship between the numbers that is here? Hope you would have found out. Very good. We are multiplying this 3 and 4 to get this answer. So, shall I write this statement 3 divided 1 by 4 in terms of multiplication? How can I write it in terms of multiplication? See here, if I write 3 divided by 1 by 4, it is nothing but 3 into, I am writing in reverse, one, not 1 by 4. Here I have written as 4 by 1. When division is symbol has changed to multiplication, I am changing this fraction alone. I didn't change anything with this whole number. I didn't change anything the first number, only the second number followed by division symbol has been changed upside down. Is it clear? So I got the answer as 12. Now even if you get any big number like 112 divided by 5 by 6, you can easily find the answer. There will not be any necessary to draw all these diagrams to find the answer. And it will be a very tedious job to draw 112 circles and dividing each and everything into 6 parts. And then finding how many 5 by 6 parts are there in all those 112 circles. It's a very tedious thing. So we got a system now that to divide a whole number by a fraction, it has to be changed into multiplication and the next number, divisor, should be changed upside down. Now I'm not using a special word. You are going to be introduced with a special word now. Okay, my dear children, what is that word? Reciprocal. What is that word? Reciprocal. Reciprocal of a fraction. That is writing upside down. If I say 1 by 4, reciprocal of 1 by 4 is 4 by 1. Reciprocal of 5 by 2 is 2 by 5. Saying upside down is called as reciprocal. How it is defined? The definition of reciprocal states that whose product with each other, if I consider 2 by 3 as my fraction, if I have 2 by 3 as my fraction, 2 by 3 as my fraction, what will be its reciprocal? 3 by 2 will be its reciprocal. If I multiply these two, what will I get? Surely I will get 1. See here, 1 3 is 3, 1 3 is 3. Here 1 2 is 2, 1 2 is 2. All becomes 1. Isn't it? So my answer will be 1. That's how they define reciprocal of a fraction. The non-zero numbers whose product with each other is 1 are called reciprocals of each other. Reciprocal of 2 by 3 is 3 by 2. Reciprocal of 3 by 2 is 2 by 3. It comes in either way. Is it clear, my dear children? Now there is a special question for you. Will the reciprocal of a proper fraction be again a proper fraction? If I reciprocate that proper fraction, will it be a proper fraction? Is it possible? Let us start with an example. 2 by 3 is a proper fraction. What is the reciprocal of 2 by 3? 3 by 2. Is 3 by 2 a proper fraction? No, it's not a proper fraction. It is an improper fraction. Similarly, you will be able to answer this question. Will the reciprocal of an improper fraction be again an improper fraction? No, it will be a proper fraction. It will be opposite. Is it clear, my dear children? Now, let us see some general types of divisions. Division of whole number by a fraction. That's what I explained you now. I am dividing a whole by a fraction. Another way is division of a fraction by a whole number. Small fraction is there. I am dividing that 1 by quarter into 3 equal parts. Again, the same concept. This division will become multiplication and it will be reciprocated. 3 by 1 will be reciprocated to 1 by 3. Next one is division of a fraction by another fraction. Here again, this 1 by 4 will remain the same. This division will change into multiplication and this 3 by 2 will be reciprocated as 2 by 3. Everywhere we are going to use the same rule of reciprocating. Is it clear? So I can say you that this is your exercise 2.4 in your book. I am going to solve few problems from this, one or two problems. The remaining you will do in your classwork note. And this time also I have not mentioned any writing symbol over the slides. It means that you are going to do as many problems as possible for you in your classwork note. At least two subdivision in each and every questions. Shall we begin now, my dear children? Okay. The first question is find 5 divided by 3, 4 by 7. I am going to divide this pi whole number by a fraction. 5 will be written as it is. Division is as it is. This has to be converted into improper fraction. Wherever you come across mixed fraction, first convert them into improper fraction. How should I convert? I should multiply this 7 and 3. 21. 21 plus 4, 25. Therefore, I get 25 by 7. As per division rule, what should I do? 5 will be written as it is. This division should be changed into multiplication and this 25 by 7 should be reciprocated. 7 by 25 and not 25 by 7. Is it clear, my dear children? So you get 5 sevens are 35 divided by 25. Even before that you can cancel it. 1 5 is 5, 5 5s are 25. So my answer will be 7 by 5. Okay. If I cancel it, I will get 7 by 5. In 5 table, I have to cancel. Is it clear, my dear children? Okay, now let us see one more example. 3, 4 by 7. Here, I am dividing a fraction by a whole number. The same procedure. Nothing difference in any kind of division in fractions. So, I have converting this into 25 by 7 divided by 5. Again, 25 by 7 as it is. This division is changed into multiplication and here I will have 1 by 5, not 5 by 1. Be careful, my dear children. You will also be making this mistake writing as it is and it should be written 1 by 5. So, if I cancel 1 5, it is not in numerator. It is in denominator now, my dear children. It is 1 by 5. So, 1 5 is 5, 5 5 are 25. Is it clear, my dear children? Hope you should make it clear. 1 by 5 and it is not 5 by 1, 1 by 5. I am cancelling this 5. 1 5 is 5, 5 5 is 25. So my answer will be 5 by 7 is the right answer. Is it clear, my dear children? I note this answer. Now, let me show you a few examples for the problem. Second, find the reciprocal of each of the following fraction. Classify the reciprocals as proper fractions, improper fractions and whole numbers. The reciprocal of 25 by 7 is 7 by 25. This is reciprocal, saying in upside down manner. And it is a proper fraction because this is smaller and smaller compared to this denominator. Now for the question 7 by 8, the reciprocal is 8 by 7. Is this 8 by 7 a proper fraction? No, it is an improper fraction because numerator is greater than the denominator. All these concepts should come to your mind in fraction of seconds. Okay, you should not every time think this is bigger, so it's improper. This is smaller compared to this denominator, it is proper. This is improper. Okay, whenever you come across improper fraction, convert it into mixed fraction using long division method. You know to do long division method. So you have to do all these rough calculation in your rough work. So I have 8 here, 7. 1, 7 is 7. What is the remainder I have? 1. So this remainder is written as the numerator here. This quotient is written as the whole part. Is it clear, my dear children? Now the next question is fourth question. I am dividing fraction and fraction. Dividing fraction by a fraction. So same rule, nothing different. 5 3s are 15 plus 1, 16 by 5. This division symbol as it is. 7 2s are 14, 14 plus 5, 19 by 7. Then this 16 by 5 will be written as it is. Division is changed into multiplication. 19 by 7 will be changed into 7 by 19. Is it clear? There is no possibility of cancellation here, my dear children. So you have to multiply as it is and write the answer. If I multiply 16 into 7, 7 6 are 42, 4 carry, 7 1s are 7, 7 plus 4, 11. So I get 112 divided by 19 into 5, 95. You have to do this multiplication in your rough column. Don't mess it up. Okay. Now I have to convert it into mixed fraction. 195 is 95, remaining is 17 by 95. Multiplication and this division conversion should be done in your note in rough column. Rough column should be maintained everywhere in every chapter, my dear children, with your neat pencils and scales. Is it clear? So today's work for you is to do problems from exercise 2.2 and 2.3. Practice two subdivisions in all questions, my dear children, and no need to take down anything from this slide. If you want, you can have small hints as the video is passing on. There is nothing special for you to take down from this slide. It's just to observe the class and practice on your own. Only practice makes perfect. You should practice as much as possible in this fraction because this is very basic to you. Only if you are capable of simplifying all fractions, you will find it easier to do max in future. Okay, so practice as much possible in addition, subtraction and multiplication and division. We have seen all the four operations. You have to revise all these four operations in your classwork note. Is it clear, my dear children? Hope you are working on your own. If you need any help, you can call me personally. Okay, my dear children. Thank you. Take care. Stay safe and stay healthy.